guys, so if you like this, if you want to know how to get a bronze goddess makeup look, then I'm your girl. Keep on watching. No, I'm just kidding. But like, for real, if you want to know how to get it and you like this makeup look, keep on watching because I'm gonna show you how to get it. And if you have not done that yet, please subscribe, please like. You can decide after you watch. Do you? No one's forcing you. But yeah, I appreciate it for you even clicking on my video. Oh, and also this video is kind of like a little bit of a review of the new ColourPop setting spray liquid highlighter in the like a lip balm, but I have lipstick on, so I'm not using that. But I will say I've used it before. I used it yesterday. I got it in the mail 2 days ago. It's good. It's hydrating. But if you keep on watching, you'll see like all about that and whatever. The set altogether, I think, was either $16 or $18. I don't remember. So it's a good price. And ColourPop's a really good brand. So yeah, keep on watching. And right now, we're gonna get into the video. So for pretty much this whole look, I'm gonna be using Juvia's Place palettes. These two. This is the Nubian 2. And this is the Masquerade. I have the mini one, the small hands. But if you don't know about these palettes, you should like for real check them out, because like they work for all skin tones, but they cater more towards deeper skin tones. So they're like super pigmented, and yeah, I would just check them out. And they're really good price. I'm pretty sure they'd like 20, 25 bucks at the most. Yeah, so this palette has all these. Palette has these. You see how these are smaller? This is the mini one. So we're gonna use these two for the whole look. So first I'm gonna start off with the large blending brush, and I'm gonna go in with this shade Madagascar right here. And so next, with the smaller blending brush, this one's from BH Cosmetics. It came with like a whole set, and if you're like balling on a budget like I am, check out BH Cosmetics. But next we're gonna go in with the color Morocco. So I'm gonna go back with that original brush and just get a little bit of that Madagascar color and blend that out. Should look a little something like that. Next, I'm gonna go in with another blending brush and go to the Masquerade palette and use color Zulu. I'm gonna focus it in the outer corner right here. And as you can see, I'm kind of blending it in just a little bit after focusing it mostly on the outer part. Go back to the original blending brush, and with no product on it, just straight the brush, blend it out. I want to go in with the color Ada and deepen up this area a little bit more, again with the blending brush. And back to the other blending brush. And I'm gonna go back in with Zulu, deepen up that outer corner a little bit. I'm gonna go back to the original blending brush in this color, Madagascar, and blend everything. I'm gonna go back in with the Masquerade palette, and I'm gonna go in with the color Casablanca. It's like this bronzy metallic color. Spray that. Sorry, I have my like fan on, so it's gonna take it everywhere and get some of that. I So I'll be honest, that's not as intense as I wanted. I'm just gonna go ahead and do a half cut crease, make that pop a little bit more. So I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Shape Tape on the back of my hand. I'm just gonna go ahead and set that down out of the Nubian 2 palette. Set that down with the Surrey color. And I'm gonna go back to the Masquerade palette and use, go back to Casablanca. I can never talk, right? This is every video. Every video. Now, we're gonna blend out all those edges. I'm gonna go back in with the second blending brush and go back to this orange Morocco color and blend around where we kind of cut the crease. And then I'm gonna go back in with the first blending brush. And I'm gonna go back in with Madagascar and blend all around. And I'm gonna go back to this one. I'm sorry, it's a lot of flip-flopping. And I'm gonna go in with, and I mix a little bit of this Aida and Zulu and blend in where those two colors meet. Okay, so that's like the finished eye look, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna do a little something extra. So I just wanna add, this part is unnecessary. You can go ahead and skip it or you can try it, it's up to you. And I'm gonna go in with my Urban Decay Heavy Metals liquid liner. It looks like this. Do like a half, like line the cut crease. You'll see. Okay, so now I'm going to go moisturize my face and do that off camera, and then I'll be back, and then we'll get into the rest of the look. Okay, and I'm back. So, next, after moisturizing your face, whatever, prime. I'm gonna go in with the Maybelline Baby Skin. If you keep up with ColourPop at all, you see that they came out with a set of four different like scents, I guess, of setting sprays, liquid highlighters, and then they come with a lip balm that like matches. And I got the Aquamarine one. This is the crystal liquid highlighter. So I wanted to kind of use these and test these out, do like a little review in this tutorial. This says it takes 1 to 2 pumps and apply onto the face using your fingers or a brush. And it says shake it up. It's like super like iridescent purple. It's pretty. Well, let's see how this looks, how it plays out. Super intense right now, but I'm gonna keep my hopes up because it is going underneath the foundation. Okay, so next I'm gonna go in, it looks crazy right now, I'm not even gonna lie. I'm gonna go in with my Too Faced Born This Way foundation. I'm not gonna, can never talk, like I told you. I'm gonna do 1 good pump of that, and then I'm gonna mix with my Smashbox Studio Skin. Told you guys it was every day. Every single day. So far the highlighter doesn't look crazy underneath the skin like it looked on top of the skin. Or underneath the foundation. You know what I mean. Okay, and so next, can you guess it? Can you guess what I'm gonna do? Shape Tape. I'm going to go in with a little bit of my Tarte Shape Tape. I'm not going to go too crazy. I'm going to add just a little bit more right to the tip of my nose, to my cheeks. I'm breaking out a little bit. Mother Nature is in town. So now I'm going to bake, of course. This girl is banging around like she's trying to knock a f***ing door. So yeah. Coty Airspun. So now we're gonna bake. So now I'm going to set the rest of my face with my Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. I'm going to wipe off all that baking. So now it's time to contour. I'm going to go in with my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. And because this is like a bronze goddess look, I'm gonna go in a little bit heavier with my bronzer, a little bit with my contour than I normally would. Okay, now that your forehead is a forehead, we can move on to bronzer. I'm gonna go in with my Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer, and guys, I can hold it up now because I got a new one. Almost forgot. I'm gonna contour my nose. Again, back to the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. And then I'm gonna bronze that part up just a little bit. Now I'm gonna clean up those lines on my jaw. And just take that Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. So you know we can pretend like we got a jawline out here. And I'm just gonna buff that away. Now I'm gonna finish the under eye. So I have this Urban Decay eyeliner. I got it on sale. It's from the Basquiat collection. Like that. And that might go really good with the whole like bronzy copper thing. Now, so for the under eye, we're gonna go back in out of the Nubian 2 palette, go in with Morocco. And I'm gonna go in out of the same palette with Madagascar and blend that out. Okay, and so now for the brow bone and the inner corner highlight, I'm gonna go in with this color Zuri. It's what we use to set the cut crease. And then going in with my L'Oreal Voluminous Fiber Mascara. Now I'm going to set my eyebrows, now that I'm all done with all my powder stuff. Now for blush, I'm going to go in with my Wet n Wild Ombre brush in the color The Princess Daiquiris. That's cute. And now for everyone's favorite part. I don't know who you are if it's not your favorite part. Can you read it? Probably not. But highlighter, of course. What else? So I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna mix these two because that's what I like to do. I'm a poet and I didn't even know it. I'm so corny. Like, my only one is like, I put all this work into getting ready and I'm like I need to stay out longer because not enough people have seen me. Like, this took work. Like, other people better appreciate it as much as I appreciate it. And if you don't, well then F you too, because I'm loving it, but that's just how I feel. ColourPop Ultra Matte Lip in the color Speed Dial. These don't have the color on them. I'm gonna go in with this Bare Minerals pink color. Okay, so back to the whole ColourPop thing. So they have this lip balm. And of course, I'm like wearing this, so I'm not gonna wear it. But I put it on the other day. And if you like that, like, blue, it's like, it's all blue, bluish purple iridescent. So, of course, this is too, but I'll swatch it for you. It's really creamy on the lips, but like I said, it has that, there it goes, that, like, those undertones. So, I mean, if you don't like it, obviously, it won't be for you. But it does feel super hydrating on the lips. So if you were to like put that on and then put a gloss or something or even lipstick like this over top, I think it would work out well. And so next I'm gonna go in with the Aquamarine setting spray. It smells good. It's like, it's not like overpowering, it's like refreshing. It's not bad. But yeah, I'll leave like a note in the description box of how well my makeup wore throughout the day with that spray. I wear this makeup, like these brands, pretty often, so I know how they like normally stay or whatever. So if my setting spray doesn't do its job, then I'ma know and I'ma let you know. Now I'm gonna go get dressed and do my hair, get ready to leave, and then show you what the finish looks like when it's all put together. So yeah, I'll be right back. Okay guys, so this is the finished look. This is your bronze goddess vibe, whatever. I just put on some body glow. And some jewelry and a new top, even though it looks the exact same. But yeah, so I hope you guys liked this. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. I'll love you forever. And if you have any questions or whatever about anything I used or whatnot, put it down below. If you have any questions of like what I should do different or suggestions, like constructive criticism, I greatly appreciate, like, for real. Just like, let me know down below. If you know me personally, just message me. I don't care, like, but let me know. Like, I'm trying to get better. I can only get better if you tell me what I need to do. You know what I mean? Again, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't. I appreciate it. I'm going now to go buy a few drugstore things. I don't have like foundation and a couple other things, and my next video is gonna be an all drugstore makeup look, so be on the lookout for that. That's another reason why you should subscribe. So thank you for watching, I appreciate it, and I will see you guys next time. Starlight, it's our light.